Is brought to you by Kingdom Message Interdenominational Ministry, a place where the undiluted word of God are fearfully and accurately given. A place where you walk in the clear understanding of the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ through His word. For more information, contact.
Praise God. Hallelujah. All right. I want us to open our scriptures. But before we open the scriptures, I want you to take this matter of peace, a very serious matter. The world don't have peace. They are trying to devise several means of peace. They set up United Nations Organization, UN. So the UN is trying to bring peace between nations of the world, continent to continent, yet there is no peace. No peace. Within the country, there are court of arbitrators that were set up. There are the arbitration panel to bring solution to people. There is no peace. Let me tell you the truth. The whole world, there is something they are running after. There is nobody on the face of the world that does not want peace. He wants peace. Though they might not know how to get it. Though they might be using their effort to secure peace for themselves. Yet, even the natural man wants peace. But let me tell you, peace is not what is going to be organized by anybody. Peace, yes, there are peace meetings, but I want to tell you, peace meeting oftentimes might not bring peace. It might even increase it sometimes, if that meeting is not organized by the Holy Ghost. So the peace we are talking about is very essential for our Christian living. It's an aspect that very, very essential. Let's go to John 14, verse 27. John 14, 27. Okay, let's read. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world gives. Give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled. Neither let it be afraid. Wow. Let me read some other versions so that we can simplify it, trust the Holy Spirit to break it down for us. John 14, 27. I read NIV. With you, my peace. Okay, verse 25. With you, but Excel of the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled and do not be afraid. Okay, I read NLT. I am leaving you with a gift.
Wow.
NLT. I am leaving you with a gift. Peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is not like the peace of the heart of the world. And the peace I give is not like the peace the world gives. So don't be troubled or afraid. I am leaving you with a gift. Peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is not like the peace of the world. It's not like the peace the world gives. So don't be troubled or afraid. Remember what I told you. I am going away. Praise the Lord. If you look at these scriptures, these are the departing statements between the disciple and the Lord Jesus Christ before he moved ahead to go and be crucified. So he was discussing with them chapter 14, chapter 15, chapter 16, chapter 17. But here, he said, I'm leaving with you a gift. And that gift is the peace of mind and heart. It's a gift. What I mean is that it is not what you work for. You know, a lot of people are laboring so that they will have peace. Yet, they will not have peace. So many people will be doing many things to have peace over children. They will not still have it. So many people will be doing many things so that in their olden days, they will have peace. Yet, they will not still have peace. Because what they put their trust upon, the source they are trusting for peace is the source of the world. The world cannot give this kind of peace we are talking about. You know, he talks about the peace of mind and the peace of heart. It is not equal to the worldly definition of peace. It's a serenity and calmness of the heart that cannot be explained. Even in the face of the challenges and storm, you discover that you are not perturbed. You have peace. Peace around you. The government of the nation cannot give you peace. I see a lot of us complaining about Buhari government. Yes, I don't know why you should be disappointed. If you are a child of God, this is not your government. Christ is the presiding head, is the federal head of our government. So if Christ is experiencing peace, I must experience peace. But if you are being moved by every circumstances, the news today, they have come. X-Men, they have taken, they have surrounded Southwest, they have done this. You begin, the opposite, the lack of peace is fear. When you see that you are expressing fear, when you see a man expressing fear, the opposite of defeat is fear. You see a man is living in fear. He's no longer, his mind is not at rest. You know, a lot of Christians today, they live in fear. And the enemy is the cause of it. You cannot operate in your Christian identity if you are operating in fear. You can't live as Christ lives if you are operating in fear. You cannot exercise authority. For you to express your spiritual potency, you must be in fear. Devil sponsor many projects in the world. He sponsor farming. He sponsor problem within the government setup. Calamity for one singular reason, so that the world will not be at peace. But the peace the world is talking about, our own peace, when the peace inside is okay, when there's a peace in our heart and our mind, Christ inside us will control every external. They will work in our favor. He said, I give you my peace. He's talking of the Holy Ghost, the Comforter. He was talking of this internal life, this Spirit of Christ. It's a gift. I give it to you to live it. So one of the fruit of that life is peace. If a man does not have peace, even if he's eating good food, it will not manifest in his body. If a man, if you are feeding him with so many things, he has all things of this sort. If he does not have this peace of mind, he can die overnight. So this peace is very essential. It's a fruit of the Spirit. This peace can only come from the life of Christ within. It cannot be produced by any meetings, UN, World Health Organization, so many things. Let me give you an example to understand what we are trying to say. During COVID, yes, last year, when the thing first started, there was serious panic in the heart of the people. They were panicking to the point that they forgot every promises of the word of God. Some people were started thinking that, is it what is going to destroy the world? I see so many Christian leaders interpreting many things. They will say this, they want to bring it. You see, who I was discussing on Sunday when we were going out, I think for administration, the vaccine that they said is from Antichrist, now they are now keen to collect it now. Many interpreted, because of the fear, they begin to give many interpretations to so many things. You see people talking many things. So as if the end of the world has come. But you see, when you see a man who is operating in the realm of the peace, wow, he will come. You know, that time there was no way we could go out. Some people say, who believe in their self, how will I go to eat? How am I going to talk? It's not wherever you are, our Father is faithful. He will bring it. We are going to eat. But because some of us, the source of our peace is outside Christ. And may the Lord open our eyes in Jesus' name. Let me tell you this. This peace we are talking about, money cannot give you the peace. Unlike the way the devil has deceived the whole world, that the more of dollars and naira they can keep, that will give them peace. It has never been. They don't have peace till they will enter ground. Promotions, from one level of promotion to the other, those does not supply you gift. And all the things of this world, and that is why you see the world, they have unsatiable desire. Because they thought those material things is going to supply peace. It's a lie. There is no peace in that. Even church has been deceived now to think when they have all those things, that's the way of peace. Instead of robusting the volume of the life of Christ to grow, because the fruit of the Spirit grow, to grow and experience Christ. No, they will not desire that. They will rather desire material things. I'm not saying it is wrong to have a material thing. But let me tell you, Jesus is regarded as the Prince of Peace, right? So that name is very key. So Jesus is regarded as Prince of Peace. So if I claim to belong to him and I'm not manifesting peace, then I probably must have detached. Because the prince, the main vine, his name is Prince of Peace. Anywhere I get to, there is peace. Whatever is in charge, is in charge. May the Lord open our eyes in Jesus' name. Let me take you to know that Jesus is a Prince of Peace. Mark chapter 4. Let me read from verse 35. On the same day, when the evening had come, he said to them, "Let us cross over to the other side." Now, when they had left the multitude, they took him along in the boat as he was. Another little boat was also with him. And a great wild windstorm arose, and the wave beat into the boat, so that it was already filling. But he was in the stern, asleeping on a pillow. And they awoke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" Then he arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still. Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. But he said to them, "Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?" And they fear exceedingly and said to one another, "Who can this be that even the wind and the sea obey him?" They've not gotten, as at this time, what can produce peace inside them. They were trying to cross over to the other side. Just like some of us, anytime we want to cross over, there are some storms. Anytime you want to take a step, you are trusting God to move further in the purpose of God for your life. Either in business, either in challenges, either in your educations, either in maritals, either in over children, you want to take it a steps. That is the point at which storm will arise. But I pray, whatever storm that has been battling, trying to obstruct your boat of movement, I command them to come tonight in the name of Jesus. Look, Jesus did not promise that the storm is not going to serve as hindrance. You can't stop storm from coming along your way. All you need to maintain is to maintain the calmness that is in Christ. And what is that calmness? Jesus just maintained calmness. He maintained this calmness to the point that he was not disturbed. In fact, he was sleeping in the middle of the calm. Do you think his spirit is not sensitive? He's sensitive. So, you know, they were fishermen. They have a lot of experience. Sometimes God will not intervene in your matter if you have not exhausted your brain, that your intelligence you think you have. So they were rolling it out, they were pushing it out, pushing it out, pushing it out. When they discovered the thing is more than their strength, they didn't remember that they have God inside, they have Christ inside their cup before. When they discovered that this thing will sink there, it's filling them, they are going to sink. They shouted, "Care not that we die," they were even insulting the master. They said, "Master, you are sleeping. Why are you sleeping and snoring like this? So you don't care that we die?" May the Lord open our eyes in Jesus' name. So when he said that, "Don't you care?" Jesus didn't just look at them. He went straight to the wind. He can't. You know why they were talking like that? Why they were insulting Jesus? It occurred to me that they lose the consciousness of the fact that Christ is inside their boat. If it is clear to them that the wind is actually blowing, and they just answer the wind back like this, "You can't sink us. The master is inside the boat." So, do you know that perfectly, without any problem, the wind will cease on its own? Number one thing they started doing is that they were using their effort. Number two is that they forgotten that they have the Lord of over the wind inside the vehicle. You know, the Bible say in that boat, when Jesus has even calmed the wind, they said they fear exceedingly. Because it means that initially, they don't believe that Jesus has capacity to speak to the storm. So they know he can heal the sick, he raise up the dead, but now to come and talk to the storm, nobody has done this. It has never been recorded. No. So they didn't know. So that's why they fear more. So many times, sometimes, there are something when we face them. Many of us live in fear is that one, we forgot that Christ is with me in this thing. He said, "In the water, I'm there with you. Inside the fire, I'm there with you." So we lose the consciousness just like those apostles. We lose it. So as soon as a sinner settles his account with the Lord, truth. Led to Christ, they will say, "You can't buy it with money." So may the Lord help us. And so now let me say this: when you give your life to Jesus, one thing must be sure. There is this peace, this serenity over. You are no longer having guilt, and that's why the Bible says there is no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus. So no condemnation. The only thing that can bring condemnation is that if you continue in sin, you are going to lose your peace. One of the regulators to make you to see that if you are in Christ or not is if you are abiding or not is regulation of peace. There is this peace. And let me tell you, if you want to even know exact will of God concerning a matter, you have prayed, but something, even when there are negativity around that thing, but something inside you is giving you peace. So many people might be saying negative, but there is this peace from your mind. Oh, that's the will of God for you. On that situation, there is peace. That peace will bring conviction of the heart. Some people will tell you, "Why are you like this? Why are you standing like that?" I have peace. Now, that peace come is it not his head to the word of God. When the word of God come to your spirit, blah, and the Lord is speaking, there is a way you will have inner peace. Let the peace of the Lord that passeth all understanding shall fill your heart and mind. Philippians. So it is beyond understanding of men. It's going to fill your heart. It's going to nod yes to the scripture. You have not been reading scripture that as you are reading like this, and the man inside will just say, oh, this will, it will be as if your mind is at rest, all the agitation has gone, all the worries has disappeared. And when they ask you, it's just that I was so blessed. You have received the word of God. So it's not his head to the yes of the revelations for the rhema that come from God. It's not his head to it. That's peace. I remember that the house we are living. Sometimes some years back, this Ijaw boy who are kidnapping in our estate, everywhere gone, because there is bunk they were doing. The security will be fighting them. And they will be killing people, kidnapping people. One day, they killed one police officer who built a house not too far from our place. The wife was just crying around 7 p.m. Everybody was inside the house. Later, the federal government brought, I think this matter is it 215? Yes. So the federal government bomber jets. They will just come looking for those gaga, and they bring all this ammo tank, like 8. There are some, when they release it like this, the whole house will be shaking. People ran out of our estate. They ran away. That estate you are seeing now, that time, everybody ran. Not that we don't have a place to run to or to relocate elsewhere. But the what gave us peace is that before we took that house, the Lord ministered to us. So there is this longer in our mouth between me and my wife there, that it is not possible that the Lord will bring us into a house for us to be affected, or either for us to be key or for bad things to happen. It's not possible. And honestly, at the end of the matter, we were safe and secure. Those people ran away. Eventually, they started running back. They were meeting us where we did. So even when our landlord then, when they were scared, we tell them that God asked us to come here. No evil can happen in this house, because we have peace inside us. So now, this peace is very key to any believer. Very, very important that a believer must experience this peace. If a believer is void of the life of peace, he's going to have a problem. And now, let's go to Ephesians 4:30. Let's Ephesians 4. Verse 30. I read. Nevertheless, what does the scripture say? Cast out the bondwoman and her son, for the son of the bondwoman shall not be here with the son of the free woman. So then, brethren, we are not children of the bondwoman, but of the free. So sorry. Ephesians 4:30. Praise God. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 30. Praise the Lord. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God. Yes. By whom you are sealed for the day of redemption. That's 4:30. Thank you. Ephesians 4:30. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God by whom you are sealed. Now, the way to maintain, I want to start discussing on how to maintain the peace, this peace of Christ. Number one, to experience this absolute peace, we must learn not to grieve the Holy Spirit of God. And what do I mean by that? Oftentimes, the Spirit of God inside us will warn us, don't take that decision. But we will go and act contrary. Or we will refuse and say no. For instance, let me give you an example. The Spirit of Christ told you that go and maintain peace with someone. Go and say sorry. And you say, why shall I say sorry? So he was the one that was wrong. See all that he did to me. Why should I do that? And you did not do it. What will happen to you is that you are going to lose your peace. I don't know how many of you have experienced that. Between you and your wife, you are not happy. Instead of sitting her down, you are now giving attitude. If you continue, you will discover that you will not be able to pray. What has killed the prayer life of many people? What has slaughtered your devotional life? Is this thing we are talking about. Because when the Holy Spirit tells you things, you give him. You do not respond. What will happen immediately is that you are going to lose your peace. Or you are the one that is diplomatic. You lie. And the Holy Spirit say, confess to this person. Engage him. Say sorry. Say lie, lie. How will he begin to look at me? That I lie. When you do that, every time you are acting in contrary to the Holy Ghost, you will lose your peace. So, the way of grieving is the way of losing it. The way of obedience is the way of experiencing peace. You see, anytime you obey the word of God, even when men around you are criticizing you, what will you experience? You'll be experiencing peace inside. Even your location, your movement, if you want to have peace, let it be that God has ordered your step. Your taking of job, your taking of contract and so many things. What will confirm that you are in the center of the will of God regarding it is that the man inside, there is going to be a peace of heart and of mind. But when you begin to have a lot of agitation, fear, restlessness concerning a thing, you have played foul. Number two, follow peace with man. We are talking of how to maintain peace now. Hebrews 12:14. read. Pursue peace. I like this. So, pursue peace with all people, comma, and holiness, without which no one will see the Lord. Let me read NLT. Try to live in peace with everyone and seek to live a clean and holy life. For those who are not holy will not see the Lord. Praise the Lord. Alright. As a Christian, we are meant to live in peace with our neighbor. People under the same roof, our co-tenant, our people in our street, people around us, we are meant to maintain peace. People in the earthly family, people in our place of works, the Bible says we should pursue it. When he's asking us to pursue it, it means to have peace with man. Sometimes you are the one to carry your peaceful, to carry your peaceful nature to go and meet them. Don't expect that he's going to come and meet you ordinarily. I don't know if you get what I'm saying. For instance, there is no way you are going to relate with all those people that there will be no issues in your office. The fact that you are finishing your work, you are doing the good boy, somebody can hate you for it. And he might not want to see your person. The fact that you are standing for what is right, he might hate you. Because he's expressing hatred to you, does not mean you don't have hatred in your nature. Hatred is no longer in your nature. What you should pursue with him now is peace. So if he doesn't want to greet you, he doesn't want to talk to you, he doesn't want to come to your office, you go to his office now. You go. The person don't like to come to your house, you go to his house. He's not picking call. Go and find the way that you pick call. We are meant to pursue peace. Because honestly speaking, if you have issue with someone and you don't, it's not resolved, and the person, as you see, you set your gaze on the person like this, I am telling you, the man inside will start rattling within you. It will start talking. That means there is issue. So, peace. It does say sometime in this piece of relationship, don't think it will come ordinarily. You have to pursue it. When you pursue it, in fact, there are standards of the scripture. You engage the person. If he doesn't agree, go and tell the another person. If he doesn't agree, take it to the leader. That's the third rank. When you get to the leader and he's insisting, he doesn't want peace, he doesn't want to talk to you. Maybe if the leader is pastor, that the Bible says consider the person and save it there. But oftentimes we have not taken steps, we just conclude about the person, we let it go. No. We should be a man of peace. May the Lord open our eyes in Jesus' name. Another thing is that always forgive men. If you are not the type that can easily forgive when they hurt you, you cannot have peace with them. You find it difficult to forgive and to let go. You can count offenses. You know, when we are studying law, is it those who can keep record of offenses? This not he did like this, he did, oh no. Always forgive. Mark chapter 11. Verse 24 to 26. Mark 11. Mark 11:24-26. I read. Therefore, I say to you, whatever you ask, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them. And whatever you, and whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive him, that your Father in heaven may also forgive you your trespasses. But if you do not forgive, neither will your Father in heaven forgive your trespasses. Can you get that scripture very well? Now, he said, therefore, I say to you, whatever thing you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. We always quote that thing very well. That when we pray, whatever thing we have, we ask from the Lord, we must believe that we receive them. It's truth. But it's not stopping there. And he now say, and whenever you start praying, if you have anything against anyone, you are the one, you have anything, no matter how small that thing, this is one of the reasons why the church cannot be answered this day. If you have anything against anyone, what did the Bible say we should do? Huh? So, all of you that have issue against Buhari, forgive Buhari. Praise the Lord. Forgive. You know why? That scripture says, if you don't forgive, your Father too will not forgive you. Invariably, it means your prayer will not be answered. So, no matter when you just want, and I know, if you have something against someone, as you want to pray, I don't know how you do you, as you want to pray and bow down your head like this, anyway, we just bring it, right? You have unsettled score. You know, you have unsettled matter. You can't experience peace in place of prayer. And this thing has cut off the devotions, the prayer of so many Christians. Somebody who can stay hours talking to the Lord, but because of terrible unforgiveness, bitterness inside him, he will not see, he will be seeing the another person. He will not see himself. Because so many, and you know, devil will sponsor it, of course. Devil knows that you are a threat as long as you are spiritually sound. He will sponsor many things so that he will bring you down. It's after your fellowship. Was in which class yesterday, brother? Okiava class. And we have a reason to go to the issue of this man, Enoch, in chapter 5 of Genesis. The Bible says when Enoch was 65 years, he begot Methuselah. From that year that he begot Methuselah, he used another 300 years with it. So the Bible says he was in habitual fellowship. I was just thinking that thing. That he was in habitual fellowship. That means no obstruction. Ah, no bitterness that assault it. He was in a constant fellowship for 300 years. Some of us cannot be in constant fellowship for 1 month. You will be sad with somebody. For 300 years, no wonder God took him away. After he has did it, he's not faking it, oh. He loved the Lord. He doesn't, whatever he said, he doesn't either storm. Bible recorded that during that 300 years, he begat sons and daughter. Some of you, the worry on children alone will not allow you to experience habitual fellowship. But this man, for where he was experienced and he was feeding them, the Lord, he was trusting God for all those things. Yet that man, he has no internal life inside him. He doesn't have the Holy Ghost inside him. He was able to walk in habitual fellowship. It challenged my heart. It challenged my heart. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Okay. Praise God. So now, let's go to let's look at another thing into how to maintain peace, how to maintain the peace of Christ. The number four is this: enter into God's rest. You must enter into God's rest. Please note it: enter into God's rest. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 1 to 7. Hebrews 4. Okay, I want to read from verse 1. Hebrews 4. I will read, I will prefer to read from NLT. If you don't have it, just listen. Hebrews 4 from verse 1. We are talking about entering into God's rest. Therefore, since the promise of, God's promise of entering to the place of rest is time, so we ought to tremble with the fear that some of you might fail to get there. For this good news, that God has prepared a place of rest, has been announced to us, just as it was to them, but it did them no good, because they didn't believe what God told them. For only we who believe can enter his place of rest. As for those who didn't believe, God said, in my anger, I made a vow, they will never enter my place of rest. Even though his place of rest has been ready since he made the world, we know it is ready because the scriptures mention the 7 days, saying, on the 7 days, God rested from all his work. But in the other passage, God said, they will never enter my place of rest. So God's rest is therefore for people to enter. Verse 6, so God's rest is therefore for people to enter. But those who formerly had the good news failed to enter because they disobey God. So God set another time for entering his place of rest, and that time is today. God announced this through David a long time later in the word already quotation. Today you must listen to his voice. Don't harden your heart against him. Praise God. Eternity. This rest they are talking about here is a rest that is in Christ. Christ is the rest. Christ is that Sabbath. You know, when God has labored 6 days, he rested 7 days. It's a type of Christ. Man was created on 6 days. The 7 days, there was rest. So every man born in Adam, if he did not enter into Christ, he did not experience second birth, he will never enter into rest. But that rest is entered by believing. He said today is that rest. That rest is now. So if you don't believe, if you find it difficult to enter believing, you might not enter the rest. So as a Christian, a lot of Christians in our generation does not experience rest because they've not entered into rest of Christ. There are many things that is still disturbing them. Their prayer points they don't rest. When the pastor is not resting, the whole member of the congregation will not enter rest. Rest is a state of mind, is a peace. Believing in the reliance on the word of God, holding on to it, that nothing will get wrong. Even when you see storm, when you see challenges that is working contrary, you believe that it's not possible. May we enter into God's rest in Jesus' name. This thing is very deep. This rest, when a man does not have it, is in bondage. His life is in shambles. The rest of God is very key. They said there is no job in the nation. A man who is in the rest will not be part up. We know that I know my own will come. He's not saying that he believed the word. He understands his father. May God give us in Jesus' name. So to crown it off, I will maybe explain that during explanation. But to round it off, let's read John 14:2. John 14:2. I read. In my father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. Okay, it's first one. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. John 14:1. Don't let your heart be troubled is the instruction. A man who is believing in God, his heart will not be troubled. The reason why the heart is troubled is because we have not come to believe. You have not trust. Even say, I believe is a lie. You have not made the conclusion of the mind that God is in charge. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. For peace to be maintained, enter into the rest of Christ. When you enter the rest, everything around you must obey. Let's bow down our head before Sam will come and teach us. Let's bow down our head to come and explain something to us. Let's bow down our head now. Let's say, Lord, please give me this peace. Christ Jesus. Lord, I have this peace. Help me to express it perfectly like Christ. Stop Jesus. Challenges of life will not disturb his peace. Situation is seen on a government of his day. Oppression does not distract him. News that is hearing will not take away his peace. Lord, I receive peace. I manifest this peace of Christ in the name of Jesus. Let's begin to talk to the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we thank you. We receive the grace to manifest this peace as many as possible among many believers here. Please manifest it over your trouble, over your circumstances.